1947, government recognition was renewed. By 1948, the administration building was occupied, although the second story was not restored. Northern Luzon Academy's reputation was further enhanced by attention from the Philippine government's Bureau of Education. On October 26, 1961, the school was the chosen venue for teacher in-service meetings that were usually held in the Lupan City due to its strategic location. Although the school was located at the far northeast section of the province, the supervisor chose Northern Luzon Academy to host an in-service in order to show the school to the 79 participants coming from 33 schools in Pangasinan province. After a demonstration by first and second grade teacher Feliciana D. Villantes, the Bureau of Education superintendent commended them.
Great job, Ms. Villantes. If I had a child in those days, I would surely establish my home in our country and put him under you.
Another building program was launched in the early 1960s, resulting in the construction of library, teachers' buildings residences, clinic, shop, home economics building, and auditorium. The auditorium named Aguinaldo Molina Hall in order in honor of the former mission and school treasurer was financed by a mission-wide fundraising campaign started in 1950. Having been granted a permit from the Philippine government and the approval of local denomination leadership to operate as a junior college, the school started to offer Bible courses in the summer of 1990 to church school teachers lacking the required religion units because they graduated from non-Adventist institutions. 40 teachers from the Northern Luzon Mission took the summer classes with Nestor C. Regioma instructor. By 1990, the school started to offer a liberal arts program in which 37 Adventist young people matriculated.
In Matthew 20, verses 25 to 28, that Jesus said to his disciples that leaders should not exercise authority over people. Instead, whoever wants to become great must lower themselves to become a servant.
Yeah. On April 11, 1992, the North Philippine Union Mission Executive Committee approved the plan of the school to become a senior college and recommended it to the Far Eastern Division Council. Leaders from the Education Department of the General Conference visited the school in November 1993, which led to the final approval for Northern Luzon Academy to become a senior college named Northern Luzon Adventist College.
All praises to God for this remarkable and historical event of our school.
Indeed, Mr. President, from Northern Luzon Adventist Academy, we are now Northern Luzon Adventist College.
The elevation of senior college status. Campus facilities were expanded with the construction of college classrooms, a library, a nursing building, and phase one of the new ladies' dormitory. Petronilo J. Barayuga became the first president of NLAC and Estor C. Leoma, the academic dean. Both men were instrumental in the development of the college. In 1992, NLAC was ranked second among excellent private schools and rated the cleanest and greenest private school in Region 1. In June 2007, Northern Luzon Adventist College was featured in Manila Bulletin newspaper because of Work Education Program. This unique program is part and parcel of the holistic and harmonious development of the physical, mental, social, and spiritual powers of the student. Furthermore, it trains students to be better self-managers, independent, resourceful, and hardworking by giving them an opportunity to experience a variety of works and tasks given by the institution. Love to serve others and fellow men, but foremost to God.